morning. Thank you for tuning in to another morning therapy with Barry B. Have you felt like your life is on autopilot? Days pass and pass, but you feel stuck in the same position all of the time. Are you somebody that wants to do and experience more in life, but you feel like you just don't ever have the energy to do it? Do you find yourself bouncing from job to job, industry to industry, but you're never satisfied with the work that you do? Or are you someone who has grown tired of life and questions and wonders why you're living? You don't understand how others around you seem to just be experiencing life in such a pleasant way and seem to be having so much joy, but your experience is unpleasant and you feel empty and depressed. And all you experience is pain, sadness, and worthlessness. If any of these things are you, you've come to the right video. Today we're gonna talk about four reasons you may be feeling empty and depressed. Believe it or not, more people than not experience these thoughts and emotions, but haven't been taught to cope, work through, and deal with these things in a healthy way. Majority of us have learned to stuff these icky, unpleasant emotions deep, deep down in the depths of our being and try to lock them up, but they still find their way and they creep out in all of these defense mechanisms and these maladaptive coping strategies. And today we're gonna talk about four reasons you may be experiencing these things so that we can start to identify some of the triggers and some of the scenarios and maybe get a grip on them and experience what we want to experience in life. If you've been feeling empty or depressed lately, make sure you watch this video all the way to the end. I promise you will not be upset with the information that I give here. The purpose of this video is to instill and bring about life in everybody that it crosses. So I hope that you enjoy and you find some life in this video. So the first reason you may be feeling empty or depressed is a lack of purpose or meaning in your life. Purpose is the thing that motivates and drives us to do or not do things. It literally is the reason that we are able to exist. Purpose. But of course, we'll have some people that will say, but life has no purpose. That's fine. I'm not here to say that life does or doesn't have purpose, but I will tell you, in saying that life has no purpose, you state that your purpose is to not have purpose in life. And if you're happy with that and you're fine with that and you find joy in that, so be it. But if not, you now have to question and wonder, am I lying to myself? Because I'm giving myself the purpose that life has no purpose, which means my drive in life is to live with no purpose and no direction. Think about it. You see, we can determine what our purpose is. That's the beauty of this thing. Our purpose could be anything. It could be not to have a purpose. It could be to have a certain purpose. Some people choose purposes that are malicious or ill intent to others, but it's still a purpose. Others choose to have purposes that heal and help other souls. That's their purpose. It's what drives them. It's what motivates their actions. And most of all, it's their choice. In this life, to be satisfied with, you must find out your purpose. You must ask yourself, why? Why am I here? Why do I want to do the things that I do? What is it that I want to do? What brings me joy? If these are questions that you've struggled with and that you've contemplated and you don't know how to get to the answer, I'm gonna post a video. It's gonna be a link like right here, or it might be right here. One of these two spots, I'm gonna post a video and it's gonna tell you exactly how to figure out what your why is. So make sure you click on that. If this is something that you struggle with, click on the video, one of these spots right here. I will tell you that my life has literally changed ever since I found out what my why was. My why is to help liberate minds from bondage and pain that was caused by others and self, so that everybody can experience this life at the highest vibration possible. That's why I do the things that I do. That's why I became a therapist. That's why I make these videos, because I want everybody to be able to tap into their mind and work past that pain and that suffering and that doubt that they have within them, to experience life at their fullest potential, whatever that looks like. Knowing your purpose is critical in overcoming feelings of emptiness and depression. Second reason that you may be feeling empty is due to neglecting self-care. Picture this. You have a little styrofoam cup about this big, right? And you're in a room. And all in that room, there's all on the floor, there are styrofoam cups that are this big also, and they're all empty. And you have your one styrofoam cup and it's full to the brim with water. Same size as every last one in the room. And you're tasked with filling up all of those cups. But there's no water source to refill your cup. So, what can you do? You can take the water that's inside your cup and you can pour it into the rest of it. But what happens? You eventually run out of water. But you don't have a water source to refill yours. So can you fill the rest of the cups up in the room? No. It's the same thing with self-care. Many of us are so busy and occupied with being parents, partners in relationships, workers at jobs, students making sure that we get good grades, athletes and being the best that we can at our sport, that we forget to take care of ourselves. We immerse ourselves and consume ourselves in these things that we begin to lose ourselves and we forget about taking care of self. We forget to ask, what about me? So take time to take care of yourself and do things that you enjoy and like. There's nothing wrong with that. Don't feel guilty about that. You have to take care of you. Or else, like in the scenario, you won't be able to fill up the rest of the cups or handle the rest of the tasks that are in front of you. You'll be pouring empty into every last cup or every last responsibility that you have. Also, check out right here. It's one of these spots. I'll be dropping a link on how to practice self-care. So if you're wondering, how can I practice self-care? I got so much stuff going on. How do I do it? Click, it's one of these spots right here. Click the link. I'm gonna let you know exactly how to do that. Third reason that you may feel empty or depressed is due to yes man syndrome. And when I say yes man, I'm not being gender specific, but it rolls off the tongue better. Yes man, yes woman, like it could be either or, but for this video, I'm just gonna say yes man. Yes man syndrome. Have you ever caught yourself agreeing to do something or saying yes to something that you didn't necessarily wanna do and you had no interest in doing, but you said it anyways? And in your mind, you tell yourself the only reason that you did it is because you felt pressured and you felt like you might let somebody else down if you didn't do it. If that's you, then you're suffering from yes man syndrome. This in itself is a very unhealthy trait and it will inevitably lead to feelings of emptiness and depression. We have to learn to establish healthy boundaries and to use the word no. There's nothing wrong with saying no, but at times we don't want to let people down. We don't want to feel like, they can't depend on me, or I'm not dependable, or they can't trust me. It's not about that. It's about taking care of you first. Again, remember, self-care. And it's about letting people know, hey, this is not something that I want to do, so I'm not gonna do it. And you're just gonna have to be fine with it. And guess what? You may lose some people in your life over this. And if you do, so be it. They weren't meant to be in your life. If people truly cared about you, they respect the boundaries that you set and they get past it. But if they don't, like I said, they probably weren't meant for your life in the first place. So learn to say no. Learn to establish boundaries and be okay with it. And don't feel bad about it. Don't feel guilty about it. I promise you, learning to say no is so liberating and it will bring fullness to your life and your experience. And the fourth and final reason you may be feeling empty or depressed is due to a damaged self-esteem. Now, when I say self-esteem, I don't mean like your typical sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me self-esteem. That's not what we're talking about. That's how most people know self-esteem. When I say healthy self-esteem, I mean the ability to make healthy, autonomous, and complete thought processes without the interference of external stimuli from either the past or the present influencing your cognition. Or to put that in simpler terms, you are fully confident in your thoughts and actions and do not base them on anything but your own physical health, emotional health, and energetic health. Now, if we've ever experienced trauma in the past or any recent traumas, and we're still triggered by those situations to respond emotionally or physically in certain ways, chances are our self-esteem is probably damaged. There are ways to remedy this though. Creating positive affirmations is, if not the best way, to help restore your self-esteem and create healthy thought processes. I got a video right here, it's right here. So I just don't know sometimes which side these links are gonna post on. So it's one of these sides that will teach you and walk you through step by step of how to create positive affirmations for yourself to help build up that self-esteem. I'll tell you something, it's not easy work, but it is possible. And it's very rewarding if you take the time and you dedicate yourself to really working on your self-esteem. You'll be surprised at how your life changes and the things that you begin to manifest when you do this. These are four reasons that you may be feeling empty and depressed. Feeling empty and depressed is something that is common, but suffered through silently, especially by men. It is crucial, critical, and important that we begin to normalize men being vulnerable and open with their emotions and expressing them to other men and women in healthy ways. There's been a stigma and culture of stoicism and toughness that has driven many men and women included to attempting and completing suicide. The reason being is because they suffer silently and they suffer alone, and that pain eats and eats and eats away at them. We have to take steps to combat this, and it's not just on one person, but it's on all of us. So let's take a step today in combating that. What I want you to do when you turn off this video is throughout your day, or if it's nighttime, throughout your next day, when you feel like asking somebody, how are you doing, or how's your day going? Instead, ask them, what emotions are you experiencing right now? If you could sum up your day in an emotion, what would it be? Because it'll elicit a more genuine response from them, and they'll tell you how they're really feeling, as opposed to, oh, I'm doing good, I'm all right, when really inside they're struggling and suffering and in pain. So if you can relate to this video, make sure you hit that like button, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel to stay up to date on all the mental health tips and tricks from a therapist that's not too far removed from the culture. And I appreciate you for tuning in to another Morning Therapy with Barry B. Peace.